Magneto. Sabretooth.
Everyone, move out.
Greetings. I apologize for not giving you my full attention. Using Cerebro to locate Nightcrawler requires a great deal of effort. Yes, he's definitely in Mephisto's realm. I've even managed a small amount of communication with him. It seems the mutant amplifier is causing him a great deal of pain. I'm afraid not. Generating a portal to Mephisto's realm has far exceeded Kurt's abilities. He's no longer able to teleport at all. Yes, he believes the Masters of Evil are intent on stranding him in Mephisto's realm once their business is concluded. But there is currently a far more pressing danger. A creature named Blackheart is stalking Kurt. You're quite welcome.
Whatever.
Yes, can I help?
Whatever you say.
Yes, can I help?
Yes.
Yes, can I help?
Yes.
Yeah.
Hello, and welcome back from Murder World. Do you require information? Despite his appearance, he is not truly a demon. He is most likely a shapeshifter, or very skilled in casting spells that change his appearance. In his own dimension, he is practically invulnerable, and he commands a great number of powerful entities such as Blackheart and Zarathos to do his bidding. Though he is called Mephisto's son, Blackheart was created out of negative energy. This energy was generated by violent crimes that occurred in the same spot over a period of centuries. Mephisto decided such a violent creature would make an excellent protege. He took Blackheart under his wing and began to school him in the fine art of corrupting innocent souls. He is a vile creature who would consume the astral energy of his victims. His power grew to such a point that he drew Mephisto's attention. The two battled, and Mephisto won. Yes, so much so that Mephisto sent him to Earth and bound him to different humans. Eventually, Zarathos was bound to Johnny Blaze, and thus was the birth of Ghost Rider. Come back anytime.
Let's do it.
Hi, what can I do for you? It was built by S.H.I.E.L.D. to analyze mutant DNA and augment whatever innate powers a mutant has. But the amplifier never got past the testing phase because of the side effects. The device was so powerful, it had a way of burning out test subjects. Any mutant that used it usually wound up in the hospital for a couple of weeks. You know me. I'm just here to help.
Certainly.
This next mission is going to be your most difficult yet. Mephisto's realm is not a place people visit willingly. But to save Nightcrawler's life, and to find out what the Masters of Evil are doing, it is where you must go. It is an alternate dimension, filled with all types of nightmarish creatures. And in this land, Mephisto reigns supreme. He watches over the astral energy of people he has duped into making deals with him. Yes. For Mephisto, there is no greater joy than ensnaring a good person in a bad bargain. Take Ghost Rider, for instance. He was willing to exchange his astral spirit with Mephisto in return for saving his stepfather from cancer. Mephisto then allowed the stepfather to die in a motorcycle accident. No one good, I can assure you. There is the vampire goddess Lilith, and Zarathos, the entity that had been a part of Ghost Rider. But perhaps worst of all is Blackheart, the son of Mephisto. Count yourself lucky if you are able to avoid him. You are quite welcome.
That was a nice job in Murder World. You turned a potential disaster into a successful mission.
I don't know. It makes no sense. Mephisto and Doom have been enemies a long time. For years, on every Midsummer's Eve, Dr. Doom attempted to invade Mephisto's realm and retrieve his mother. When Doom was very young, his mother made a pact with Mephisto. She promised her astral spirit in return for the power to destroy a baron who was impoverishing her people. Right. She couldn't control the power and wound up killing almost everyone in her village. She died shortly after and became a prisoner of Mephisto. Yes. Oddly enough, Dr. Doom and Dr. Strange teamed up and went to Mephisto's realm. Together, they freed Cynthia Von Doom. Without a doubt, the Tome of Asarius listed the coordinates of Mephisto's realm. With that information, Doom could properly attune Nightcrawler's teleportation portal. Anytime. Yes.
Hey, congratulate me. I managed to hack into the SHIELD database and get more info. I found out that SHIELD's think tank, the Imperium, is working on something called Project Warlord. I'm not sure, but I've got bigger problems. SHIELD's hot on my trail, and I've gotta hide. There's only two places I figure I can go. The Baxter Building or the X Mansion. Ask Pym which one would be safer.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I gotta say, Mephisto's realm is not on the top of my must-see vacation spots. Let's think about this, shall we? I'm Iceman, and that's Lava World. Not exactly a winning combination in my book. Sorry, I guess I'm afraid I might become a head case in a place like that. Well, there have been times I've lost my powers because I got scared and just turned them off. Miss Frost says all my power problems are in my head. She must know something. One time she took control of my powers and used them at a whole new level. I've never been able to match what she did. If you need anything else, I'll just be here chilling.
Roger that.
Hello, what's new? I guess since we're all superheroes here, I can talk about it. Yes, I'm Matthew Murdock, the trial lawyer. It's a little more complicated than that. The Kingpin hired Elektra to assassinate Foggy, but she stopped once she realized who he was. It was a big turning point in her life. That started when I was a kid in grade school. The bullies called me that because I was such a bookworm. I think they were trying to be ironic. Yeah, my father was adamant that I study as hard as possible. He didn't want me to become a boxer like he was. Yep, Battling Jack Murdoch was his name. A good fighter who was maybe a little too proud. His manager killed him for not throwing a fight. It was because of me. I was in the audience, and I know he couldn't bear to lose in front of me. Sure thing.
Yeah, yeah.
Certainly.
Hello. It's good to see you. Do you need something? Well, I used to work for Hydra, but when they sent me out to kill Nick Fury, I figured out I was working for the wrong team. Not quite. I went off on my own and played superhero in San Francisco. Then I died, and that put a damper on things. Doctor Strange was brought in. He saved me, but because of the spells he cast, I lost my powers. I was completely normal. I became a private eye for a while, but then Hydra came around and offered to restore my powers. Of course I did. I was nothing without my powers. But once I got them back, Hydra forced me to join S.H.I.E.L.D. as a double agent, or they would have taken my powers away again. No, not really. The joke was on Hydra. I was working for Colonel Fury all along. My pleasure.
Okay.
Affirmative.
I would warn you. Mephisto's realm is a vile dimension. Few that have traveled there ever return to tell the tale. Our own Doctor Strange, the mightiest sorcerer on Earth, barely escaped that fiery land with his life. Yes. Years ago, Stephen traveled there to aid Doctor Doom. In a Vishanti contest to choose the next supreme sorcerer of Earth, Dr. Doom came in second to Dr. Strange. According to the rules of the competition, the runner-up is allowed to ask one favor of the winner. They are Agamotto, Hoggoth, and Ashtore. A mystical trinity who appoint one sorcerer to protect this universe from evil. Little is known of the Vishanti. Other than choosing a new sorcerer supreme, they rarely show interest in your cosmos. You're welcome, human.
Got it.
We must be truly wary of Mephisto's realm. The denizens of that land are without mercy. Several times. Perhaps most notably when Dr. Doom and I battled Mephisto to free Doom's mother. Doom was willing to offer me in exchange for his mother, but she refused to let that happen. And in that moment, her spirit became too pure for Mephisto. He then released her from his domain. Yes, I would consider the Eye of Agamotto to be the most valuable of all my arcane artifacts. It not only augments my power, but it allows me to see the truth. There is no lie or illusion that can stand before its illuminating light. My cloak of levitation has proven to be quite valuable. In times of battle, it can even function as another set of hands for me. I also frequently require the Book of the Vishanti for spells and the Orb of Agamotto to search for trouble. You're quite welcome.
What's going on? I don't know. And believe me, I looked everywhere I could. S.H.I.E.L.D. is dead serious about keeping that information from prying eyes. Well, there's one thing I can try. But first, I've got to avoid getting caught by S.H.I.E.L.D. I'm not going to do anybody any good stuck in a super high-tech maximum security prison. Because I've been running through their database like a rabbit in a carrot patch. They don't like that much. Hey, they sent 24 agents into the building I'd been using as a base. If I hadn't decided to run out and grab a latte just before that, I'd be in custody right now. I'm just in it for the money.
Magneto.
All right, team, let's roll.
If you insist.
Greetings. I apologize for not giving you my phone. Yes. Yes, can I help you?
Sabretooth.
Everyone ready?
I apologize that the Orb of Teleportation sent you to Murder World. I should have foreseen Baron Mordo's treachery. Perhaps. I find that I must ask a favor of you. While you are in Mephisto's realm, if you should locate the Eye of the Shadow Queen, would you bring it to me? Rest assured that the orb will now take you to the proper destination. The spells required to counteract Baron Mordo's magic were quite difficult. I found it to be an intriguing test of my skills. That was a spell Baron Mordo had cast to disrupt the Orb of Teleportation. It was designed to activate immediately after anyone used the orb. Correct. It is a testament to Mordo's skill that he was able to cloak the spell's true function from Clea and Doctor Strange. It is a talisman of value to no one but me. The bauble serves as a reminder of a creature who caused me a great deal of turmoil. She had me abducted and taken to her dimension. It required the combined might of Doctor Strange and myself to destroy her. It is a pleasure to be of service.
All right.
Hi, what can I do for you? What do you mean safe? Like, will it catch on fire or fall over in an earthquake? Well, the Baxter Building is home to the Fantastic Four, and sometimes Reed Richards does work for S.H.I.E.L.D. So yeah, there could be soldiers there. I'm not sure, You'd have to ask Professor Xavier about that. You know me. I'm just here to help.
Greetings. I apologize for not... Yes, I'm not sure I understand your question. No, they aren't. I don't believe having soldiers within my home would sit well with the X-Men. You're quite welcome.
Team, this next mission takes you to Mephisto's realm. It's an alternate dimension that's filled with fire and brimstone.
Gah! Why can't we ever be sent to an alternate dimension filled with lonely supermodels?
Because we're going to save Nightcrawler. You got a problem with that?
Nope. Sorry. I'll just be quiet now.
Best news I heard all day.
Why is Nightcrawler in Mephisto's realm?
Dr. Doom somehow forced him to teleport a group of them to that dimension.
How is that possible? Nightcrawler's abilities were never that strong.
They used a device known as a mutant amplifier. It magnified his powers far beyond the norm.
What's this amplifier doing to Kurt?
We estimate it's overdriven his powers to the point that it's causing physical damage. You have to move fast, or it'll kill him.
Do you know why the Masters of Evil are going to this dimension?
No. Any knowledge you gain would be helpful. So far, we've been completely in the dark as to what Doom is up to.
But Kurt comes first. We ain't risking his life. You got it, bub.
I understand, Wolverine. Nightcrawler's safety is the number one priority. So get moving.
You've arrived in Mephisto's realm, and I would urge you to move with haste. My power is waning. I won't be able to protect Nightcrawler much longer.
Thank you.
the game! Another victory!
Of course.
Roger that.
Have a good rest. Of course.
I got a critical situation.
Affirmative.
Yeah, yeah.
Shields are under attack by a creature known as Blackheart. To boost the psychic shields, Jean Grey will be using the Orb of Teleportation to join you.
I've made it, Professor Xavier. I'm with the team.
Excellent. I would recommend Jean stay where she is, so that she can concentrate on aiding me. Watch yourself, Jean.
Not to worry, Professor. I'll create a mental shield of my own.
Then the best of luck to us all.
I can't chat for long. Helping Professor Xavier is taking all my energy. Did you need something else? He's created a number of barriers to keep Blackheart from getting to Nightcrawler, but Blackheart is slowly tearing them down. Yes. Without them, Blackheart would have gotten to Nightcrawler long ago. Since I can't use Cerebro at the same time as Professor Xavier, we decided it would be best for me to be closer to the shields. I don't know much about him, other than he's supposed to be the son of Mephisto. Blackheart is certainly as sadistic as his father. He enjoys forcing people to make choices they normally wouldn't, choosing the lesser of two evils.
My pleasure.
Of course. Yes.
My target's down.
Yeah.